In this video, I will explain how to perform client transport and then import into target system. That is called client export and import. So let us go to our SAP system. Just log off whatever the systems are already logged in. So let us log on to the source system, that is DIS system, and in this scenario I'll copy a client from this source system to this target system, that is from the DIS system to QA system, not using remote client copy, by using client export and import method. First of all, decide what is the source client within the source system and log on to that particular client. Double click on this and log on to 001 client, sourcing its user account. Okay, to transport client you need to execute export T code. Client export T code, that is SCC 8. So enter T code and hit enter, and target system you need to specify to which system you want to transport, and to make this experiment successful you should already configure TMS in your SAP system, and target system should be specified as QA system here. That should be part of your TMS configuration, means that system should be defined in the TMS domain. Okay, you can understand about configuring TMS and definition of the systems within transport domain in transport management classes. Okay, if you want, you can refer those videos and come back here and do this experiment so that you will understand clearly about this concept. Once you choose target system, click on the schedule as background job from the application toolbar and click on continue button here and select immediately, click on schedule job, and this is the verification screen here. Just click on continue button, and depending on the data available in this particular client, it is going to create up to 3 transport requests like this. Client specific transport request, that is DASK number, DASKT number, DASKX number. Okay, so let us continue here. And background job was successfully scheduled, log is displayed in SCC3. Just click on continue and look the log using SCC3. And related to exports, you have to click on exports button from the application toolbar so that the client export information will be displayed. That is this thing. Double click on it and it is still processing, and double click newly transported log, that is double click on this and it will show the information. Once it is successfully completed, that information, that message should be displayed here. And during this time, what it is going to do is that it is transferring the files at operating system level, that is trans directory within the C colon. Double click on USR and double click on SAP, double click on trans directory. Under trans directory, there is a co-files directory and data directory. You can look into the co-files directory for the newly created transport request, that is this is newly created transport request. Just look at the time, 10:59. Okay, and this one and this one, KX7, KT7. In the same way you can look at data folder RT7 and RX 7. Okay, these two files should be generated. Once these two files are generated, and you can start import this particular client into target system. Just let us refresh here in the SCC3 screen. Yes, exported successfully. Now let us go to target system, and these two systems are installed in the single host. That's why there is no need to copy these files to the target system. If you have installed QoS system in another computer, another host, then you need to copy these two files from the data folder and same two folders, two files from the co-files directory to trans directory of the QoS system. So in this case, both the systems are installed in the single host. That's why the trans directory is common for both the systems. Okay, so that without copying the files directly, you can log on to the target system, that is QoS system, and there you can create new client and start the import process. Okay, just before starting import process, just you need to create new client. Quickly we'll create a new client in this system. So just I am logging into the 001 client within QoS system to create new client. So using SCC4, you can create new client. Already available clients are these, that is 000, 001, 066, 997, 999. And let us create another client using change button. Click on continue here. Click new entries. And 995 client I am going to create. That is new client. 995 customizing city Mumbai. And INR client role is customizing client. Okay, click on save button here and log off from the system, that is QoS system, and log into the QoS system again using newly created client. And newly created client will have SAP star and pass as the password, and this particular user is defined at kernel level, so that this particular user will have full authorization within the system, and you can execute the T code, STMST code, to import the transport request into this client, so that the client will be imported into this target client. So before importing it, just let us look at the data which is available right now within the fields of screen using SUCOM, that is I am trying to create a company, and if I try to create a company using some name like this and click on the create button, you should not be able to see any data inside these drop downs like this. So there is no data available for country, and there is no data available here also. So once the client import is successfully finished, let us come to this same screen and look at the information, then the information should be available. Okay, so that means you can consider that the client import process is completely done. Now let us do the import process, that is using STMS T code. So hit STMS, you will get the initial screen of transport management system. From here, click on overview, click on imports, and the target system. You double click on the target system which we have specified while exporting client. Double click on here. So it should display the related transport request here. Yeah, these two transport requests are displayed. Now any of the transport request you select and click on the truck symbol, and it will ask you to enter the target client. Target client which we have just created is 995. Double click on that client and click on the import button from the application toolbar, and it will ask you to enter the password of 995 SAP star. Right now the password is PASS. Hit enter. So that the import into QoS system started, the message will be displayed. Means import has been started. Just click on the refresh button to see the information about this import process. Just see the truck symbols are denoting that the transport, that is import, is running. Okay, so let us click on the monitor button here. Just click on import monitor button. From here also you can view the log, that is status of this particular import. Just click on refresh, keep on refreshing so that you should be able to see this type of tick mark. So once you see the tick mark, the client import is successfully performed. So it will take few minutes of time, so let us wait. You can also expand it. So it's done, you see. Okay, so now you can go back and let us try to create the company, new company, using sucomp and hit enter. Here if you try to create a new company using the same name earlier we have used, just click on the create button. It will not allow you to create the company name because it is already exists. That means the company name has been copied from the source to target system. Okay, so let us try to change it, or let us try to create another company name that is like this, giving different name, and click on the create button so that now you should be able to see that same screen as we have seen before importing the transport request. Okay, let us look at the information which is available right now. The information is available. That means if you click on the drop down, you are able to see this company, Mr., Mr. and Mrs., Miss. This information is copied from the source system to target system. Okay, and in the same way, country information also will be displayed here like this. AD, Andorra, AE, like that. And even time zone information also will be available like this. So once the client import is completely performed, that's why you are able to see this information. Now let us log off and log into the system using its own user. Even you can view the user information using SU01. Actually, by default, you should not be able to see any user accounts in newly created client. But we have done client export and import into the system. That's why you are able to see this SAP user account. So let us log off and log into the system using SAP user. Okay, SAP user is actually the source user that is copied to target system QoS and to the 995 client SAP user. Okay, so in that way you can log on to the target system and it is fully completed. Now last step, that is client post processing, should be done. That will generate the objects. Okay, that is to done the post processing, the T code is SEC7. SEC7 is the T code for running post processing. Okay, just you have to click on the schedule as background job and immediately click on schedule job and click continue in the verification screen. And background job was successfully scheduled. Log is displayed in SEC3. You can also view the log of this thing in SEC3. Okay, let us wait up to the successful message here. Okay, just click on refresh. Import successful. This message you should be able to see. That means you can confirm that import of client is completed successfully. So this is the way you have to export and import clients using transport management system. Here we have not used RFC destination like remote client copy. It is not remote client copy. The purpose is same, but it is not remote client copy or local client copy. Okay, so that's all about exporting and importing clients. I hope you understood. Thanks for watching. If you have any doubts, you can log on to my website, that is www.punarvasi.com, and you can leave your message using contact us form which is available in this website. Okay, thanks for watching.